Good morning, everyone out there. I am Karin Braxton, and I am coming to you live today from Bozeman, Montana. It is October 29th already, 2024. Can't believe we are at the end of October. I totally forgot that we had this week yet. I thought I was going to Wisconsin for my mom's birthday. But really, that's next week. The first I leave on Election Day. So anyway, I am here this week and we are having a craft along. So I have sent out some kits already and some of you will probably be ordering from me and receiving kits after you see the video. So let's see if we can find ourselves on our computer and see if that we can, oh, there, I think, yep, got it. That was fast, pretty fast anyway. Good. Now we'll see who's going to pop on here. And if you're watching and you enjoy my videos, please give me a thumbs up. That helps. Hearts, all those things. Good morning, Levon, and sharing. And I am going to have some prizes for sharing this time. So I'm going to draw three names of people that share. Be sure when you share that you say shared, because sometimes comments are hidden and it says that people have shared, but I don't know who it is. So good morning, Kathy from Fort Collins, Colorado. Hope you're having a good day with your mother. So share and like and all those things. Make sure you subscribe. If you're watching on YouTube later, make sure that you ring that bell and subscribe so that you're notified. Thank you, Becky. Thank you for sharing. I appreciate that. Stacy, thank you for sharing. Let's see if I can find my comments on my... Okay, there we go. Yeah, thank you so much, everyone. How are things in South Florida, Stacy? My husband is down in Boca Grande right now, checking on our house there, which our house wasn't too damaged or anything, just a tiny bit. And the water in the garage, but and there's a few other problems. He doesn't have any hot water this week while he's there, so that's a little tricky. Good morning, Jeannie. But he said the island is really devastated. It's people are working like crazy. So many homes got water, 4, 3, 4, 5 feet of water. I'm glad that's nice. And that sounds really pleasant, Stacy. Good weather, so not so humid. That's a night. November is a nice time in Florida for sure. Good morning, Carla from Appleton, Wisconsin. So we have three projects today. We are going to be using the Yuletide Village set. It is one of my favorites in the catalog. I love it. And if you like coloring, this is probably a good set for you. You can color with your blends. You can color with your ink pads. You can use an ink pad like this and squish it and use it and use your blender pen or your Wink of Stella. That works too. And you can use colored pencils, watercolor pencils, and you can blend that with this blender pen. If you don't have a blender pen, this is a really inexpensive. I don't know. It's just a couple of dollars in our annual annual catalog. So that's been in the catalog for many years. So, okay, let's get started. We have all kinds of things happening in these last few days. Remember, it's the 30% off on all kits. So this is the time to stock up for Christmas and birthday presents. I'm going to order a few more kits yet. I've ordered a lot this month. I've saved a lot, but I have a lot of gifts. So I'm going to make sure I have enough for different grandkids, some of the granddaughters especially. And anyway, so make sure you have enough kits on hand. And they're discounted almost $3. So this is a great time. That Expressions of Love, I think is the name of it, just came back in too. That's a beautiful set. Also, we have our starter kit promotion going on that is ending in two more days. That is a great deal. You get an extra $56 of products. So you get $155 worth of products and you only pay $99. And you get the free shipping and you get a free paper pumpkin and then you get a discount after you shop if you become a demonstrator. So there's no obligation. I would love to have you on my team. And if you are at all interested, if you're even thinking a tiny bit, please call me, text me, email me, and we can chat about it. Okay, only a couple more days for that. And then it's always a great deal. You can do this anytime. You can buy the starter kit anytime. But it's extra special right now. And then usually the other time they do that is, we never know exactly, so, but usually during celebration, there's some kind of a special promotion. Okay, let's turn the camera down. So we have a lot to do. I'm going to show you some projects from my, I have a couple things going on this week. I have a team meeting luncheon on Thursday here at my house. And then on Saturday, I have an all-day stamp camp. And I still have a couple openings for in-person. I can also ship these, so for these kits to go. It's two classes, and it's you get a lot of things. You get a whole package of reindeer fun paper. You get a whole package of the peppermint gems, whole package of the druzy gems. You get two ribbons. You get some twine, some peppermint twine, all those things. And it's $60 and you make 10 projects. So we're going to be making 9 cards and one box. And we're going to be using the reindeer fun. Thank you so much for sharing, Kelly. Good. Thank you. Thank you for the hearts. We're going to be making, using the reindeer fun, or reindeer fun, I think is the name of the stamp set. I'm not sure if that's the name of the paper, but so that bundle, we're using that bundle in the morning, and in the afternoon, we're using festive words. So here's a card from the festive words. So it's sort of an easy set, another really fun set, just opens up like this. Let's turn the camera down. You can see some of these projects. Okay. So let me know if you're interested in anything. Good morning, Christy. Good to see you this morning. Thank you, Jeannie. Yes, it's great paper. I forgot to tell you to close your eyes, but I guess you probably know that. So, oh, I'm glad you're sharing with your friends and family, Christy. That's so nice. And I know you're going to be you'll have to leave after a while and go to lunch where you live. So that's fine, too. Don't worry about that. Okay, these are some cards that we'll be making. This is a fun fold with the reindeer. This one, isn't that sweet? And here's another one with that reindeer head. We're going to paper piece that. A couple of these where we paper piece. Oh, I have another one too. I didn't bring it out. We're doing 10. I only brought a few up. This is a real easy gift card holder. So this pops out. You can put your gift card in there. This time of year, we need lots of cards and gift card, you know, tags and things like that. And then here's the one using that festive word stamp set. So these are just a couple things that we're doing this weekend at my stamp camp. So I thought I'd show you those quick. And then we are going to be using the Yuletide Village today. This is in our mini catalog. This is the mini catalog, and it is on page 56. Page 56. And Yuletide Village, I just loved it from the moment I saw it. It is $19. It's a very inexpensive set. Good morning, Brenda. Good to see you this morning from Illinois. Here's another set of stamps that I really like. It's a very large set. It's called Falling Snow. I totally missed this for about the first month. I never saw that stamp in the catalog. You all have seen this one, The Shepherd's Care. I've done it before. I love this set. I love this whole page, actually. So page 56 of the mini catalog. Also, we are using the Snowflake Sky 3D. This is a embossing folder. I've used this one a lot, and it is just terrific, especially it works really nicely with this set. If you are ordering a kit from me, all of the things will be embossed for you. But that embossing folder is in our annual catalog. It's called Snowflake Sky 3D. It's an $11, you can't really see it very well, but it's on page 129. And all of these things are typed up, and if you order from me, you get the typed tutorials that look like this. So this is what the tutorials look like. If you are just watching today and enjoying the video. You can see my directions at the end. I will post them. They're all typed up already. And all I do is after the video ends, I just pop them up in there. It takes me about 1 or 2 minutes. So Yuletide Village. Now, for a craft along, those of you who are who would like the kit, this is what the kits look like. They come all packaged in a plastic bag with them. And you get 6 cards. You get 2 of each design. And all you have, this is free with a $40 or a $50 purchase. With a $40 purchase, you get the 6 cards. With a $50 or more, you get all of the cards, the 6 cards, you get, plus you get a package of gems like this, and some snowflakes, and a treat. So just for a little bit extra, you get a little $50, $60, $70, whatever, you get this kit from me. So I will send that out in the next day or two. And I appreciate your orders for sure. And I appreciate your sharing. Some of you are going to make these and you're going to look at the directions and you'll be just good to go. Okay, let's start here. This is a photopolymer set. So we're going to be using, today we're going to start with the church and then we're going to go to this one and then, or this one, and we're going to make a little scene at the end. So we're going to bring in, I designed this card for a swap. And I'll show you what it looks like first. Oops, it just landed in the wastebasket. It's a buckle card. This paper is from the Treetop Wintry Nest, I think it's called. And then this is not a buckle card. Well, maybe it's a buckle. It's a hinge for sure. It's like that. And there's that church. I also made it with the village scene too, so wouldn't have to be a church. But anyway, for my swap, I did the church. So anyway, there we go. Now you can see it a little bit better. There we go. This is my host code for a few more days. Okay, let's bring these up and we're going to make this hinge card. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to be using the for the words, the sentiment, we're going to be using the wintry treetops. And the paper is from the same set. But I like that sending thanks and this thinking of you always. I actually cut off the always. I just use the thinking of you on this. So that's what we're going to do. Okay, let's get our pieces. I'm going to set my little church right there so I can see it. And we're going to bring in the pieces. Everything in the kits are cut and embossed and scored for you. So we're going to bring in all these pieces. First of all, we have a base that's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. It's a little different. It's actually like a regular side folding card, only I cut off, three-fourths of an inch right there. I'm not sure if it's 3/4 of an inch. Let me measure that and see. What did I cut off? 1 1/4 inch I cut off. Okay, and then this is the piece that's going to go on top of that, the DSP. That's going to go on top. And then on the inside of the card, we have it just gives it a little bit more layer, a little nicer appearance, a regular 4 1/4 or 4 by 5 1/4. And then this white is going to go on top like that. So we're going to do that. And then we have some, this is from the fancy, something fancy. And then I have a hinge. My hinge is 1 1/2 by 4. And I scored it already at 1 inch. So that's going to be, we're going to use that for the hinge. The designer paper that goes on top of the hinge is 1 1/4 by 2 3/4. Like that. So hopefully I won't forget to do that right away. Okay, and then we've got our squares and things. And I already have, these are the stitched squares from the Stylish Shapes. I've got a 3 by 3 white And then a pool party that I stitched with the, I didn't stitch it on the sewing machine. No, I die cut it. And then I used a stitched square, the smaller one. And this is the one I embossed with the snowflakes. And you can see those snowflakes. So it's a, let me tell you about outside. I walked this morning. It was so, it was all foggy. It was so foggy. It was like we were socked in. Now the sun is out and now it's coming through the window. And I didn't, wasn't expecting that. But anyway, it's not very warm out, but it's a pretty day. It's cloudy, but the sun is peeking through. Anyway, so let's put this together. Let's see one's here. I want to stamp a little church scene on my envelope, but I don't want to forget that. I'm just going to quickly put this together, and then we're going to do our stamping and our coloring. So, get these pieces out of my way. But it was so weird this morning. I got up and it was still dark, but then after it started getting light, it's so weird because it stays dark so long. I couldn't believe it. It was so foggy. You couldn't even see anything. But anyway, I guess it was not that way in town, but it was here. We're a little higher in the mountain. Okay, I'm going to just put these. All these measurements will be on my post, so don't worry about those. You can either take screenshots, of course, but they will be there, and you'll be able to look at them. Okay, this paper, you can see the birds on it from that treetop nest or nests of winter, whatever it's called. Not sure. It's really pretty. Okay, now we're going to take that hinge. This is the important part of this. Before we put our, we wouldn't have to actually put it inside on a normal card because it is white, but we're going to have a hinge. So here's my hinge. I'm just going to take that off and put this on. I'm going to just glue that on. Where's my little silicone mat? Right here it is. So I'm going to put that on like this. Just a little bit of, okay. So now we can put some adhesive on this little part. And then we're going to put that underneath like this. It's hard to keep things neat when I'm working on this. I'm just going to fold this like this, right in the middle, and glue it down. So it flaps up like that. Do you see why? Can you see that hinge part right there? That's the part we're going to cover up with this now. So I'm going to just give this a good, put that on. And then that's all going to be hidden. I love this kind of a fun fold. It's not hard. See, it just goes like that. Isn't that pretty? Just like that. Just the way it is. And hey, Jeannie, it's sunny there in Ennis. Yeah, that's good. I'm glad it is. It's going to be a pretty day, I think, once this fog sort of lifts here. Okay, let's put this part together. And then we're going to do our stamping. So we're going to put our white down first, then our pool party. I just love pool party. Pool party and red are one of my favorite combinations. I'm using a red door on this card, like a lot of churches have, especially Episcopalian churches always have red doors, but I think a red door is very pretty. Touch of red. Okay, there we go. And that's our piece. And it's going to go on our card like this. We're going to just wait for a second. I'm going to set that aside. We're going to do our stamping now. I'm going to bring this, get this out of the way. Don't want to lose that though. Bring in my piercing mat because these are photopolymer. We're going to stamp Thinking of You. And let me get my pieces here. My church and Thinking of You. I actually just cut this off because I just, not always, because sometimes, you know, I just didn't think that was, I liked it. Most things fit better when it doesn't have an extra layer on there. So that was my thinking. That's not great. Let me try another one here. I've got two of them. There we go. That one's a little better. For sure. Okay, and now we're going to do our church. We're going to just do that in black. So, oh, we're going to do our inside. We're going to do our inside. I could have probably, this would have been probably a little bit better if I had stamped that part sending thanks. And now because we're going to put this right in, you're all wondering, you're going like, oh, move your ink pad. There we go. We're going to put that stamp, that thanks right in the middle. I'm going to clean this on my chamois. Thanks. Sending thanks. We always need lots of thank you cards this time of year, I think, between birthdays and Christmas. And I don't know, I like to have a good stash on hand. Okay, let's take this aside. And now we're going to stamp our church. We're going to do that on some, I've got some scrap paper here. It says stamp here. So sometimes I forget and I don't know where my scrap paper is. You probably are going, that is so weird. But anyway, the more I'm organized, the better it goes, I think. So, okay, I'm going to stamp this upside down because it is a big stamp, pretty good size stamp. We're going to be fussy cutting this church out. So I'm going to give it a good little press like that. And while we have our stamps out, I am going to also stamp the one for the next, card, we're going to, for the second card, we're going to do another house. So we're going to do, I'm going to just put this on this block like that. And I'm going to give that a good stamp right now too, because then it'll have a chance to dry and then we can just go right to it when we get to it. This one, I want to have a little bit of a hill on it. So I'm going to put it up a little higher like that. Okay, and then we're going to be stamping these again for our scene. So we have a lot of stamping to do today. Alrighty, now let's give this some coloring. And so let's see once here. I'll just set this right there so you can sort of see it. And so we don't lose things. All right, we're going to color a little bit. And I'm going to use my lightest. These are the colors I'm using. I'm using the Granny Apple Green for my tree, and I'm using some Crumb Cake and the red for the door. And we're just going to use, I'm going to use the dark Crumb Cake for the, like the things that are, let me just see if I can make sure this is down low enough so you can see me coloring this. And I'm just going to do just some of this, just a little bit to give you an idea. So what I like to do is do my dark things first, like this. And then I go back and I'm going to come in with my Crumb Cake. And I'm going to start coloring like this. I'm going to put a little bit on the roof where the snow is melting. Do the steeple. Like this, and then I'm going to just very quickly color my church like that. And the doors are going to, I'm just going to go around like that. The door is going to be red, so we're going to give that a little red coloring like that, a little red on the bow. Now you can use your watercolor pencils also. I'm going to color this tree Granny Apple, and you can see that it has some snow on it. So we're going to have some parts that have snow and some parts that are green. I'm just going to sort of, not really sure, you can just sort of make it up whatever you want. There we go. And this is, the wreath is going to be green. I just thought this Granny Apple Green is sort of a nice color. If you wanted, you can, you just keep going. And you'd add Wink of Stella and things like that. Wink of Stella is your friend on these cards for that snow. And I would give all of this some Wink of Stella like that. And then I would start fussy cutting. And when you're fussy cutting, remember, I have one already done, but you're going to be moving your paper, not your scissors. So just like that is how you're going to be doing it. It's really quite, quite easy. It doesn't take too terribly long. So it's something you can color while you're talking on the phone or watching TV or something. But there, you get the gist of it. I'm going to just set that aside, and I can always finish it because I already have one that's finished. So, and we're going to put our card together now. Take my reading glasses off so I can see your comments. Thank you for sharing, Carla. I appreciate that. So I will, from all the comments today, I will choose a, I'll get those all down. And let's see, once this is going to be, I made it a little bit too big on here. So I already have my, I'm just going to give this a little cut off like that. I think that'll be better. Yep, that's perfect. And you can, I just sort of guessed at this. I mean, you know, you can do whatever you want. But so I will include some scrap paper for you to stamp on, of course, some white. And so this part I'm going to, you know, you could also stamp on the white and then color it so you wouldn't have to fussy cut it. You could do that. I did that on the one with the houses, I think. You know, but I like it. I sort of like it popped up. And I like the snowy background in the back. That's why I did this extra little bit. So that's what I did for my swap card. And now we're just going to pop it on like this. It's okay if it goes, extends a little bit over the edges. It doesn't make any difference. And let's see, we're almost done with the first card. So it's going to go on like this. You're gonna have to make sure now that we put our very, very sticky. I'm gonna use my Seal Plus. This is my, the really dark blue one. That's the extra strong. That is a good one to use for anything that you have. Anytime you have a fun fold, excuse me, it's nice to have that, that extra, excuse me. That extra sticky. And now we're going to add our words. We're going to put those on flat. And I'm going to switch back to my seal. My regular seal is my go-to. I am not sick. I just, talking made me choke. Here we go. And there is our card. And now let's see, where are my gems? Did I bring some gems here today? Huh, I don't think I did. And I forgot to stamp on the church. Let me see if I have some gems here. Well, let me see. I think I forgot the gems, but let me just go grab some from my counter. Here's the next card that we're going to be doing. Here's the one I just finished. So you can take a look at those for a moment while I get the gems. And I am just looking here for the gems. Well, I don't know where they are. I'm not sure, but I'll just use some that will work just fine. We're going to put these iridescent rhinestones on. They will be fine. So we're going to do that. The ones that are included in your kit for this are the berries. The ones that look like, what did I show you? The ones that look, they have the cluster of berries. But anyway, and I have some of those, but we're not going to use those. We're going to just use these because this is what I grabbed. I could reach first. So we're gonna put one big one right there. These will be just perfect. And we're gonna give a little bit of shine there. I love these take your pick tools. A great little invention that Stampin' Up came up with. There we go. And our card is all finished. So isn't that just a pretty card like this. Thinking of you, sending thanks and much love. There we go. And there is our first card. And now on to our second. Let me see if I can see any. Good morning, Denise from Colorado. Jean, thank you for sharing. Carla for sharing. Thank you, LaVon. Okay. Oh, thank you, Sherry and Robin and Jackie. And good morning, Susan. Okay, no problem, Christy. You watch later. Okay, the second card that we're going to do is this one. I'm going to move this up a little bit. Thank you. There we go. And there we go. Can you see that okay? I'm going to... This one, I love this arch. This is from the... We've had this now for about a year and a half. Thank you, Denise, for sharing. This is called The Garden Meadow. I think many of you remember this set. Hey, Jolene, good morning. Good to see you here. Yes, I know that Yuletide set. I love this Yuletide set, too. So this is The Garden Meadow, and if you don't even buy this, that's fine. But I'll tell you what, I love this arch. I love the fence, everything that's in here. It's really a great set, and I use it a lot. Actually, we are using this. So when I cut this out, it looks like, I'm going to put these gems here so I don't lose them. So on this card, so this is what we did. I took a 4 by 5 1/4 and I ran that arch through the die cutting machine like this. And this is the piece that we're not using today. I'm actually using it in my reindeer fun class. Actually, I think it has two pieces right there. Yeah. So this is the part that we're going to use here. So really, you get sort of two ideas. I've used this a lot. You've seen it before. But it's a great, great way of doing things, I think. Okay. We already have, this is what we want to end up with. And so this is what we're going to be coloring. I'm just going to slice this off so I can finish that later. And this is our card. I want to have this be sort of a little bit of a big snow, like, so I'm going to trim it like this. Okay? And then on here, I'm going to come down and I'm going to trim it so it's like a hill, like that, okay? And then I'm going to be cutting it or coloring it. Well, let me just finish cutting. I'll just go ahead and trim this out. This is really fast fussing cutting. There's nothing hard about this set at all. It's pretty much straight lines and just try to make some things curved. There we have the whole thing cut out already. It's that easy. Okay, so let's give this a little coloring. I'm using the paper from Sentimental, whatever it's called, Sentimental Wishes. It's the one, it's a Stampin' Up paper that is in the catalog that they donate some money to food insecurities, I believe is the one they're saving for this year. I'm not positive though. Anyway, I cut this 3 3/4 by 5. So that's that. And then I'm going to be, this is going to go in here like that. And I have cut some trees out of this glittery glimmer paper. And this is from an online exclusive called Frosted Trees. It's beautiful, beautiful set of dies. So if you order the kit, you get this already die cut. And I'm going to be sticking this in here like that. So what I'm going to do first is let's go ahead and do some coloring and then we'll sort of stop and do the rest of the card. Okay. And let's bring this down a little bit closer. And I'm going to use my this green I thought was so pretty. I'm going to use some soft seafoam. So that's what I'm using. And we're going to be using some shaded spruce, the light shaded spruce and the soft seafoam. And I'm going to just set that aside for a second. And I'm going to show you how I would do this. Again, I always start with my, like doing the little trim around the windows and the
soffit or whatever it is. Like these are the shutters. Like that. And do my door. It's going to be dark. Like that. And the chimney. We don't want to forget that. Okay. So that's the shaded spruce. And then the seafoam. We don't use seafoam a lot, but it sure is a pretty color. And I just thought it was perfect for this house. And I'm just going to come in here like this. And very quickly, I'm going to leave the snow like that. And that's just how fast it is. Now, if you wanted to, this is some lemon lolly. I'm going to put the lemon lolly in my windows. It looks like there's a little bit of light. There we go. And that is how fast that is. I actually had one already cut out for you, but I think we'll just go ahead and use this one just because I just did it. We're going to add a little Wink of Stella to it. Let me just show you. I'm going to add some Wink of Stella right on here to the snowbank. I'm going to put some Wink of Stella on my roof, on the snow. There we go. And your Wink of Stella is... I think it's like $8 or $9 in the catalog. It's one of the greatest things. You should definitely have that. Everyone should have Wink of Stella for sure in their supplies. And it does, you know, you use it and it does get used up after a while. I'm just going to put some adhesive on this. I'm going to put it on the sides. I'm going to sort of leave the bottom a little bit open. I'm going to just leave it a little bit open right through here on the bottom because I want to tuck those trees in. There we go. And now I'm going to put these trees. I'm just going to sort of slide this in here like that. I'm going to put a little bit of adhesive on the bottom. I'm going to leave the trees loose. So I'm just going to sort of tuck it in like that. And I'm going to lift this up a little bit and tuck it like that. There we go. Just that easy. Okay, now I'm going to put it on my base. My card base is 5.5 by 8.5 standard 4.25 scoring. And here we go. So now I'm going to just, and you know, another thing you could do, I did not do this, but good morning, Martina. Good to see you here this morning. Hope you're feeling better. You could emboss this with that snowy embossing folder. That would be pretty too, but I'm not. Okay, so we're just going to put this on our card. Like that. And there we go. And there is a card. It's pretty just by itself. You could add some words even. Let's see. I think I'm going to take this tree and snip it because I don't want to lose it. I'm just going to take that one off. I think that's what I did. I can't remember now. And now I'm going to just put this up like this. I'm going to pop it up with some dimensionals. And where are my dimensionals? Oh, there they are. We're going to get our little dish of dimensionals out. And I'm going to just... These are my adhesive sheets that I just cut up and keep in a little custard dish. And we're gonna cut that one a little shorter. There we go. One of my customers keeps her little dish of cut up pieces like this from these adhesive pieces in the plastic stamp cases. And it works really great for traveling or, you know, when she comes to class or whatever. I really like that idea. That was Lisa's idea. Okay, I'm going to put this down here like this. And so we've got these two trees peeking out, this one peeking up. And then this one I'm going to tuck in right there like that. And this one I'm going to add a little bit of combo green glue. Just going to put little dots on it. You don't need much. It's a big glob right there. It will dry clear, so that's the good thing about this for sure. And it will dry on here, and I can just peel it off. There we go. And there it is. Oops, now I got that glue on my card. Let me just move that right there for a second. And what did I do not have my gems out here. So we're going to, do you see how I used the little clear cluster? I used the clear berries up here and then the berries right there. And that's what I had in mind. But we will, well, since we don't have them, we're going to just use what I have out here. So we're going to put these on. I'm going to put a couple right there. Put another one down here. And then I'm going to put a, I'm going to put a large one on. They're sticking everywhere. Oh, that's a little bit big. I think we'll use a medium one right there. And I think we'll use a second medium one right there. And there is our card all finished. How do you like that? Here's our other one. Looks like I only used two, the other tree is hidden there. But isn't that pretty? Looks great, I think. And these trees are beautiful. They cut out, that's from the frosted forest, I think. Frosted forest, frosted trees, one of those things, I can't remember exactly. It's an online set for sure. Okay, that is our second card. Remember, all the dimensions will be under the at the end of the video, under more. So we're going to use those. So, okay, and our last card. Let's see once here. And I do appreciate when you do order from me, please use the host code. That helps me get the prizes for you. And our third card is going to be this scene. I'm going to move those. This is our card. Oh, and this is the Sentimental Christmas paper that we're using on this. So we are also using the stamp set called Peaceful Season. This is a really nice one. It has a lot of those dies that have nice labels, but a lot of great words. I guess in the last card, I forgot to stamp. You could stamp anything on the inside. I didn't stamp anything. Just totally forgot about that. On this one, we're going to use Love from Our Home to Yours. There's also a Love from My Home to Yours. If you're single, that would be a, isn't that nice that they've done both of those? So that's the stamps that we're using. That's in our mini catalog, Peaceful Season. And this one, we're going to be using this really fun gingerbread paper. I love this. This is an idea I saw by Diana Gibbs, and we're going to use this on for the card. So, okay, we're going to be using the regular white base. We've got some gingerbread paper that's 4x5¼. And then I have a radiating dies label. That's this one. And then I've got some of these. This is from, I don't know, can't remember the, this is from the Season of Green and Gold, I think it's called. I'm not sure, can't remember exactly. I think it's on my directions. And then I have a strip of the stripe, and this is from the make a bow or something. The stripe 1x4 inches. And we're going to put this together. We're going to make a scene. And so we're going to put this all together. First of all, let's do that. And then we'll do our stamping. Okay. I don't know about you, but it's really fun to make a scene, a stamping scene. You don't want to make a scene where things go bad. That kind of a scene for sure. But a scene where you're creating something pretty is fun, isn't it? Okay. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Stacy. I love this set too. It's a real keeper for sure. And we're going to put this red stripe right down there on the I just think this red and white is so pretty against this pecan pie. Okay, now let's do it. So our card is all done. That part of it's done, and we're going to stamp our scene now and our words. Let's do that next. Let me get my little mat. Where did I lose my, oh, there it is. We're gonna do this. Okay, We're going to give, and we're going to do a, let's do our words first. We'll do that. We'll do our words first and then that. And let's see, here we go. We're going to do this in real red. And we're going to need some red berries on this, just, but I don't have those either. I don't know what I was thinking on this, but, and I double check everything too, but there we go. And you can always take those off and change them up. So now we're going to get our stamps and close up our red ink. I have got my houses already on here, and I'm going to put this other house on. I'm going to just set them next to each other like that. Okay, and we've got a tree. And some snowflakes. Where is the, and the fence. We have a little fence also. So we're going to bring these things in. And our black ink pad. Things are sticking to everything. So let's set that aside for a moment and bring our black ink up there. It's a big stamp, so I'm going to do it upside down. Let's bring this over here. Ink up our stamp like that. And we're going to put it up about here because we're going to put a little fence in there. So give it a little stamp like that. We're going to put a little tree down a little bit further down the hillside like that. And now my fence, where is the fence? Here it is. So we're going to build the fence. This is really a neat fence. I don't know which is which side though. I think it's, I don't know. I'm gonna have to, there, yep, that looks good. We're just lining it up. There we go, just like that. And then we need some snowflakes in the sky. So we're gonna close up that black and bring in our pool party. From the first card. And we're just going to add, now, you know, you could do, I'm just going to add some snowflakes up here in the sky. Like that. You could use a mask. I didn't use a mask on these, but you could for sure. But I don't think it's terribly necessary to cover that up unless you want the snowflakes down there. But we don't need that really. So, okay, now on this one, I wanted to make sure that all of the windows have the yellow in them. The lemon lolly, isn't that a fun word to say, lemon lolly? So I'm going to do all these windows first. Just put a little, you don't even have to go very slow on these. You can just give them a little dash of color in there. In those windows, like it's winter time and all the lights are on. I think we go set our clocks back this weekend. It seems like it's always around the time I go to Wisconsin. That's when we set. I am going to Wisconsin. I will be live next Monday, and I am sure about this because I was totally wrong last week when I finished doing the video, and I said, and by the magic of TV, I have already colored this whole thing for you. There we have it. So now you don't have to watch me color everything. But anyway, last week when I finished doing my video, I went, oh my gosh. My sister said, I thought you were coming for Mom's birthday. And I said, I am. And I realized that it was not this week, but it's next week. My mom's 98th birthday is November 6th. And I think what I'm going to do is I need to maybe in one of my emails put my mom's address so people can send her. She would really enjoy some birthday cards. I know she would. She's always been a stamper up until just a few months ago, really. She's really not capable of doing it anymore, but she up until maybe July, she was still making cards. So we're going to put this on like this. And nothing has popped up on this. It's all just colored with some Smoky Slate, Crumb Cake. This is Pool Party. That's the soft seafoam. And then that is the shaded spruce. Oh, I'm glad you love this, Stacy. Yes, you do need to order this stamp set for sure. And on this one, I use the red, which you would use if you're making this. But because I don't have my gems out here, I do have some gems, but they're not the right ones. So we'll just use these instead. We'll put this on like that and cover up. Those holes are meant for ribbons, but you can also cover them up with gems. Actually, I think I'm going to use the medium gems like that. We'll just take those off, and you can always, if you peel them off with your pick tool, you can just put them back on the plastic, and there we have it. And that card is finished too. So there you go. And an easy card. Love from our house to yours, and then you can write something on the inside if you'd like. And those are just really, really fun cards to make, I think. Now, this is the stamp, Yuletide Village, and this is something you would need if you want to get the free kit. You would definitely need this stamp set or some similar house set that you might have. You might have something else that would work too. It doesn't have to be this one, but you know, it's against Stampin' Up compliance for us to stamp for you, so I can't stamp. You use your own stamps and your own ink. I have cut everything else for you and embossed and scored and everything else, and I send everything to you just like this. And these are the gems that you will get. So the gems are the berries. These have been so terribly popular. But they were out of stock for so long. This is what you get with the kit. It's called Cherry Cobbler and Pearl Adhesive Back Berries. And then you also get some of these stars, these white epoxy stars too. So all that is with a $50 or more order. And this is a little cocoa package that we made for you. And with a package of cocoa and just a little extra treat in there. So, and then you get all the directions already printed. So that is it. And don't forget, just a couple more things. I don't want to spill my water over there. That starter kit special ends on Thursday. That's the last day. And I definitely would love to have you if you've ever even thought about it. It's the best decision I made 12 years ago. 12 and a half years ago, actually. I've been stamping for about 20, but I've been a demonstrator, Stampin' Up demonstrator for the last 12 years. So the starter kit special, you get $155 worth of product for $99. Also, you can order any of the online exclusives with your starter kit. Don't forget the 30% off on all kits also. That ends on Thursday. So that's the last day. Then they go back to their regular price. I'm going to turn the camera back. There we go. And remember, all the directions will be at the end. So give me just a few minutes, and as soon as the video is finished and it posts, then I will get the directions up to you too. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Remember, the thumbs up and all those, the hearts, all those things help Facebook let them know that people are watching. So, or you're on, if you're on YouTube, make sure you ring the bell later on and subscribe. And leave comments. I love reading the comments when I have time later tonight or this afternoon. So that's always really fun too. So next week, ladies, next week I am going to Wisconsin, but I will be here on Monday. So I'm leaving on Tuesday, which is election day. So on Monday, I will come to you at 10 o'clock. Mountain time, same time as always, only it'll be a day earlier. Okay, so that's all what I have planned, and I didn't make a mistake this time. So next week, it is November, and I am going to Wisconsin.
Wisconsin. So I will see you next Monday. I will let you know on Sunday night. Make sure you get my emails. If you're not on my email, send me a message. Text me, send me a message on Facebook Messenger or something, and let me know that you'd like to get my emails and all that too. So, alrighty. Thank you so much, Kathy. Appreciate that comment too about beautiful cards today. Well, they're really, this is a fun set for sure. I love it. It's a fun one to play with. Oh, I want to show you a couple more cards too. This was a swap card that I got. This was a swap that Lisa Makakis made this one in one of my swaps. Thank you very much. Here's one that I've made. We're going to be doing this in my cookies, cards, and coffee in November. This is another scene using, and then I use that pretty gold and beige paper. But this one I used with my Wink Estella and my blender pen and the ink pads. I didn't use my blends on this. So you can use colored pencils, blends, other things too, or besides your blends. But blends are my very favorite thing for sure. Anyway, that's it for today. I meant to show you those earlier and forgot about it. Okay, I will see you next Monday. Thanks so much, everyone. Bye-bye. Have a great week.